Anyway, I did make a little bit of progress when I got back from dinner. The only thing I did though is just pass by that big fan up there, because I just wanted to try to get through. I was gonna try to get the warhead to the chest, but it was too annoying, so I tried it for a little bit longer, but I pretty much gave up because it was too annoying. So I just need to find a way to disable the electricity on that fan. And hang on a second, I'm going to close my web browser because my game is lagging again, so. Alright, there we go. Let me go ahead and open this chest. Yay. Alright. Let me see. I'm gonna have to go in again and hopefully not get zapped. Okay, I see. It's gonna be tricky. I need to redo this, I think. Okay, let me go in the first one here. And hopefully this will be it. Yay. Now I can get out of here. So I need to find the statue's head. Can't open that until I have it. Yay, treasure. Okay, save spot. Let me see something real quick. Alright. I'm gonna swim through here. I'm gonna get that treasure if I can. But I need to get that statue head too. And I'm gonna have to be careful when I swim through not to get electrocuted. I need to. Ooh, ow. I wasn't staying in the part where it looked like it was happening. I need to be more careful, though. Let me try that again. Alright. I'm gonna keep an eye on it. Okay, there we go. Let me get this through. I'm gonna get my ship. And let's drop it off. Alright. Now I'm gonna have to figure out how to get this through. Because there's another beam of light up here. And I think I'll have to block it off. But I also need to make sure that the ice doesn't wear off. So I think I'm gonna have to keep my ship here. To keep the beam from activating it, I'm gonna re-ice it, and that's gonna blow up. Darn it. That's fine though. Let's see, I need to figure out.
The city's defenses continue to wage an all-out assault against Meryn and her tiny submarine.
Okay, that opens that. There's going to be a lot of these. Let me see if I can open this now. And they're going to be sucked into that whirlpool area. So I'm going to have to figure out. Let's see. How to detonate them at the right time. Let's see, what is this chain doing? I can't tell yet. So I'm gonna have to use the sonar and make it so that they can blast and activate that switch remotely. And this might be a challenge. that activated two of them. I think that's going to be too early. Yeah, certainly. I'm gonna activate this one. Actually, that didn't reach, but that's fine. Then I got stuck in the current. That's totally fine, though. Alright. Let me try to enable this at the right time. I'm gonna try to do it halfway through. I have a feeling this still might be too early. Oh, that was perfect. Yay. Alright, got it. Now I need to detonate one right here, so I'm gonna try to do it by getting them here. The timing can be a bit tricky. I need to do it farther down so that it has more time. Maybe here or something. This... no. Okay. I'll have to do it even further down. I'm gonna try on this side. And hopefully that'll do it. Okay. Yay. Now let me hit that switch, if it will let me. Get out of the current. Alright. And hit it. Thank you. Alright. That wasn't terrible. Some more smog. What's in here? Okay, some more crates. There's a little cubby there, but I don't think there's anything in it. Oh, hi, Hermit Crab. Kind of random for him to be there. I'm gonna save up my money for the lightning claw.
The Famori must have used them for transportation. Had her father made it to one? Had he found a way to escape? Marin knew it was wishful thinking. But the idea still gave her hope.
How can you dive through this and not suffocate, though? I don't get that. Maybe it has to do with that shell that she wears that makes it so that she can breathe underwater, but still, you can't breathe smog even if you can breathe underwater. Hello, Guardian. With the weird music. Alright, I have a feeling it's going to be a few more hits. Oops, that was totally not intentional. That could have been bad. Okay. There we go. Whoa.
Stretched out in all directions. The golden
Whoa.
Of the forbidden city gleamed in the distance.
This place is so cool. Let me see if I can get this treasure. Because the last one of its kind was tricky. Come on. Gotta get everything in time, I guess. No. Let me. Thank you. Yay, I got it. Okay, I'm gonna look around for a little while. Just to see if there's anything I can get before I go down. Can't do anything with that. What is over here? I don't think... I don't see anything to aim this beam at, so I'm gonna leave. Is there anything else I can actually get? Let me get this chest. Oops. Yay. I'm glad I actually know how to get those now. Alright, let's see. Oh man.
Meryn spotted her father's boat lying on the sea floor.
Uh-oh.
Suddenly, a violent current grabbed hold of
her. Uh-oh.
It pulled her inside a powerful Fomori machine known as the Architect. The machine had once built the tower.
Oh boy.
The spires of the Forbidden City. But now, its purpose was simpler and more sinister.
Ow.
Scaring a turtle into its shell appeared to cause the beams of that color to shut off.
Ooh. Ow. Alright, I need to be careful of those beams. Boop. Then I say that after, or right before I boop one. Not the kind of thing you should boop. Boop. Okay. Don't get zapped. Alright, let me take these guys out. And I'm gonna have to swim down and disable this. I'm sorry, turtle.
The only way to help them escape from the machine.
Can't do that, no. Okay, let me head in the middle here.
As Meryn entered the innermost room of the Architect, a large red turtle activated an alarm.
Oh boy.
Suddenly, the insides of the machine.
This is so cool, by the way. This, like, blew my mind when I saw it at first. It's so cool. Okay, this, I'm gonna get out of the ship. And the red is gone. I need to get through here. I guess I'll have to defend myself. And I'll just swim through here, I guess. Ooh. Disable the turtle.
Their shells could now be moved safely around.
Ah, yeah, okay.
Careful not to hurt them.
There we go.
This was for their benefit, as well as her own.
Okay, I can't get past there. Let's see. No, nothing down there. I can get to the ship. I can go up here.
Some of the beams were controlled by sensors. But would any large object trigger the sensor?
I'll have to see. Would this work? Maybe. Or is that still up? It's still up. Okay. I can't go over. Oops. Didn't mean to push him. Okay. I'm gonna head down and see if I missed anything. Oh, I need the ship. Yeah. I see now. Oop. Are you going to stop? I guess not. Okay. I'll have to go out and take the turtle down here and drop it off right here. Gently. Okay. We melt this. Ooh, I got zapped. Okay, I got the treasure, so let's see. I need to disable the purple, but this is the orange guy. Put him right here. I need to get something else, too. Oh, the red. Yes. I need to eventually get him in a shell, if possible. Whoa. This is so cool. Okay, I'm stuck in this red beam area. Okay, actually not stuck. I just had to wait a little while. What is this? I don't know what that is. Oh. Alright, there's a beam here. I'm gonna get out of the ship and hit that globe thingy. Okay, the turtle is stunned.
The red turtle continued to evade Marin.
I need to do this.
Him into taking a more dangerous path.
And leave the ship. And I need to do this. Oh. There we go, okay. And I need to do... Hang on a second. Let me deal with these first. Alright. This... Ooh. It's so hard to do this. Because of my controller sometimes, it's hard to be really precise. Alright, let me take this turtle and put him right here. And let me do this again. No, actually. Okay. Leave the ship, maybe. And now I need to... Alright.
Sent the turtle back into his shell. But a piece...
I see a thing here.
Marin recognized it as a Fomori's...
Yay! Now I have this. Alright, cool. I need to, let's see, melt this. Oh no, no, actually.
The submarine shot out a burst of pure
Yay. Energy,
shaking the architect and scattering broken glass in all directions. This
Yay.
Might be Marin's one opportunity to escape.
I think you got that right, narrator. Yay! Now I'm not gonna be stuck by those glass panels anymore. Okay,
As the last piece of the great Fomori machine collapsed, Marin heard the sounds of distant turbines.
Oh boy.
That had pulled her in was now reversed.
Oh boy.
Out into the sea and toward her father's boat.
Oh boy. Come on. Yes. Oh no.
Enormous red tentacles grabbed her submarine, cracking its propeller. The unseen beast pulled her down into the darkest depths and left her at the bottom of a deep, rocky trench.
Oh boy.
Her submarine broken. Marin sat helplessly at the bottom of the sea. She opened her father's journal. On the last page, he had written a note to her. Her hands trembled as she read it. My dearest Marin, I now realize I may never see you again, and I feel that I have failed you. I'm sorry for all the times you went hungry. I'm sorry I could not buy you pretty dresses and paints and books of your own. I wish I could have given you a happier life. Please know that I love you more than all the world. Marin put down the journal, and her eyes blurred with tears. She didn't want pretty dresses or paints. She had a happy life, and she just wanted it back. But the first time since her journey began, Meryn had lost hope. She felt the slow, dull realization that her father was truly gone. She watched as the water seeped in through the cracks in the submarine's hull. She could no longer will herself to go on. As the cold water slowly rose up around her, there was a tapping sound from above, and the hatch creaked open.
Hi, Swish.
He gently picked Meryn up and pulled her out of the trench. He carried her out of the Forbidden City, through caverns and caves she had never seen, until they reached a place so beautiful that Meryn was certain she must be dreaming. Her to an undersea garden of 1,000 colors. Beautiful corals of every hue stretched out like blooming summer flowers. Dazzling schools of fish swooped up and down all around her. Meryn had never imagined a place like this could exist below the waves. What she didn't know was that the whole sea was once covered with these gardens, and that this was the last one of them all.
This place sure is beautiful. But yeah, these little guys, the cuddle pups, they like to follow these glowing orbs. So I'm going to try to bring it with me and get him to let me through. I'm going to get this treasure as well. But I have to be fast with these orbs because... they wear off after a while, and they burn out, so to speak. Ooh, need to go get another.
If the sea garden could be saved, the marrows might still live on.
Indeed that. Okay, excuse me, Mr. Jellyfish. Let's see. Oop. Hello, treasure. Ow. And then I died. Okay. I won't try to do that yet, then. Why can't I move? What? I'm having a glitch, so I'm going to go ahead and reload the game since I just had that save point, so it should be fine. I like the artwork on the loading screens, though. They're pretty nice. Alright, let's see. I'm still having this glitch, which is concerning me. I'm trying to use the analog stick to swim, but it wasn't working. Okay, it's working now. I just switched something on the back of my controller off and on. And it seems like it fixed it, thank goodness. Okay, I need to get the cuddle pup over here, I guess. Anyway, this place is so, so beautiful indeed. Hi, Swish, I can't get to you because the current is too strong. Hopefully, I will at some point, though. Excuse me. Come on, buddy. Come on. These things are adorable. Okay.
A cluster of brilliant red marrow eggs shimmered like giant rubies. If the sea garden could be saved...
And I need to go... I need to remember... Oh, please don't die out. Come on! Come on, come on! No? Okay. Come on. Don't burn out, please. Okay. And I need to not get killed by these things. Come on, buddy. Come on. Oh, please don't burn out. Okay. Yay, there we go. Let me get this collection of coins. Hey, buddy.
Marin was shocked to see her submarine repaired and waiting for her. Did you do this? She asked the hermit crab. And for a moment, she thought he was blushing beneath his shell.
Yay. Thank you, hermit crab. My buddy. Thanks, buddy. What a nice crab.
As Merin swam toward Kara, she felt a wave of panic.
Uh-oh.
The Merrow was dying. Merin asked her desperately, What can I do? How can I help? Kara's voice was slow and weak. Fix him, and he will show you, she said. Kara closed her eyes. She didn't have the strength to say more. Very sick. But Swish was there to care for her. He would fetch scallops for her to eat and guard her from any enemies. Merin knew the best way she could help was to find a way to repair the clockwork seahorse.
Yeah, we need to repair him. Alright, let me go ahead and save. Man, this place is gorgeous, by the way. Whoa. Okay. So I need to find the parts of the seahorse, and there are some all around different areas. So I see that there's one in Skeleton Reef, there's one in the Glow Kelp Forest, and there's one that's going to be... Oh boy. Deep down into the maw, which is a scary place, to say the least. So, let's see. I'm gonna try to collect some treasures while I'm in the garden. And I'm gonna need to find a glowing orb. And I'm gonna need the cuddle pup again.
A series of visions flashed through her mind. Each one showed a different location in the world.
I'll go ahead and burst this thing, but I'm not gonna use it yet. Alright, so I need an orb and I need the pup back, I think. Well, actually, I'm gonna go the other way first. That music. This game is really, really pretty. Alright, that's plenty of money. That certainly helps me a lot. And pretty soon I should get that claw upgrade, the final one, because that should certainly save my hide in some future combat. Okay, there's a mine here. I need to blast something, but I'm not sure what yet. Oh, right there, okay. Alright, there we go. And I seem to have missed a treasure, so I'm gonna go back up into the turbine and let's see. There's something over here. Ooh. Didn't mean to blast that thing. There we go. Wow. Whoa, that's a lot of money. Alright, I'm going to go get the claw upgrade. And then venture further down, I suppose. Okay. Where are you, buddy? Okay, over here. Alright, let's get that upgrade now. Yay. And let me check again, actually. Is that the... Okay, that's the final claw upgrade, so that should do it, I think. Alright. And there's a Merrow statue, which is pretty cool. Alright, something should be up here. and below. Oop. Oh no. Why did that kill me instantly? I'll have to go get those treasures again.
Visions flashed through her mind. Each one showed a different location in the world. She marked them on her map, wondering what she might
find. Couldn't get those treasures again. The anemone are a pain. That's a difficult word to say, though. Which is hilarious. Okay, got those two. And there's this, and then there's the sonar thing. I'm gonna get that. Alright. Let me get another mine, and let's see. I wonder how those Fomori Sentinels actually crashed, though, because I don't think there was any, like, enemy vessels or anything that could have taken them out. So that's a bit confusing to me. Okay, I can't get the one down there because of the anemone. So I'll have to get other ones. And after I get a few treasures, I think I'll stop for today. Ooh, I didn't even see that. I'm a derp. Oh, come on. I just drifted into it by mistake. I'll have to get those treasures again. That's so annoying.
She marked them on her map, wondering what she might find there.
Okay. Let's try this again. Without explosions this time. Sonar. Chest. And mine. Gotta go fast. Come on. Alright, phew. Gosh, the anemone are a pain. This time I need to not do that. Okay, that's an orb. Ugh. Your ship naturally drifts, so it's kind of hard to prevent that from happening. Plus, they do so much damage. Okay, I'm gonna get out of there before I just, like, kill myself from the electrocution. And I'm gonna have to get to the next save spot, being extremely careful that I don't die. Is there something back here? Ah, got it. Hi, Cuddlepup. Alright, give me 1 second. Can't go around there. Alright, let me just go through the exit and find a save point, and then I'll go ahead and stop for today. When the coast is clear, no pun intended. No, I don't want to get zapped. Get the claw again. And get the sonar. And there we go. Anyway, it was a lot of fun playing today, and I hope you all had fun watching. Even though this game can be kind of hard at times, it's a really beautiful game. And again, I really recommend it. And I'll probably try to play more tomorrow. Anyway, I'll start it later on, and it was fun. And thanks for watching.